ಆದಿಶಂಕರಾಚಾರ್ಯ ಅವರ ತ್ಯಾಗ ಸಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪರಿವರಾಜ್ ಯಾತ್ರ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ಕಾರ್ನೇಷನ್ ವಾಕ್ ಡಾನ್ ದ ಪ್ಲಾನೆಟ್ Mary was feeling very thirsty and he looked around. There was no one, only a small arak shop, the village arak shop where they get that padani from the palm tree and then they sell the village arak. I don't want to say alcohol or a drug. It's a kind of a village drink. It also gives you a little kind of a kick. So only that was there. And the villager, poor man, he was a little reluctant to offer this to sannyasi. Shankaracharya said, no problem, don't worry, give. And he drank. And his disciples were little, what is this? Being a sannyasi, how can you drink arak? But anyhow, they did not question Guru, but they also drank. And after a few days, again Shankara had little thirst and nothing was around and there was a guy who was melting metal for making weapons. Melted iron was ready and he was trying to pour into the mold and make weapons. Shankaracharya was feeling thirsty. Adi Shankaracharya, and he asked that guy, "Can you give me something?" He said, "Nothing is there other than this metal." He said, okay, pour the metal. He asked him to pour and drank the whole thing. The yaga power. The stomach digested the whole thing. He did not die. He looked at the disciples and asked, whoever drank arak because I drank, please come forward. Of course, none of them were that matured or had that kind of a tyaga whose stomach can digest everything and detox. But I tell you, even if you start practicing tyaga in your own level, you may not digest melted metal, but you will be able to detox your whole system. That much is easily possible. Adishankaracharya is our guru. And I wanted all of you to know, after thoroughly doing research for almost 2 years, the mother documents of Madhurayadinam, which I studied when I was there, and other documents released by Kamarajar University, Madurai Kamarajar University. Madurai Kamarajar University has published a book, Madurai Temple Complex History, and other books which I had the opportunity to read, study. After thorough research, Sthana Varalaru, Sthaniga Varalaru of Madurai, Temple, Adinam, Mutt, Madurai, Shyamala Peetam, Sarvanga Peetam had 6 Matadhipathyam. Under it, Madurai Adinam is one. Jnanasambandar Madam is one of that 6. After thoroughly studying the whole history, now I am making this statement very responsibly, with a lot of joy and happiness. With the multiple resources, historical facts and truths, bits and pieces putting together and corroborating, I am making this statement. Adi Shankaracharya ascended the throne of Shyamala Peetha Saranya Peetham of Madurai as 117th Guru Maha Sannidhanam with the title, the coronation title, whenever Sannidhanam ascends, when a person ascends the throne of Shyamala Peetha Saranya Peetha, he is given the coronation name, the coronation title, Shanmatasthapana Kesigar. Of course, then it comes Sri Jnana Sambandha Desiga Paramacharya Swamigal. Shanmatasthapana Kesigar with the title as 117th Guru Maha Sannidhanam in that long list of 293. He has ascended the Shyamala Peetha Saranya Peetham throne in Madurai. I am responsible for the statement because after doing thorough study, the Sthana Varalaru, Sthaniga Varalaru, documents published by Madurai Kamarajar University, books published by them, and all other, many other research materials, which I was able to lay my eyes with enough of proof, after doing thorough research, studying the Sthana Varalaru, Sthanigar Varalaru, everything, I am making this statement. Madurai had 6 Madadipathyam under Shyamala Peetha Saranya Peetham. Of course, now, fortunately, only one Guru Parampara is still alive, unbroken. That is that Madurai Adhinams, that 293 Guru Maha Sannidhanams. Tell me that only this Guru Parampara is unbroken. So all these other 6 have been merged into this one, and this is keeping that whole chain alive. But there was a time this Peetham deputed 6 people to take care of all the 6 Matadibhatyam. So I have some of the digital scans to present. This is a scanned copy. I don't have the original document. Original document must be in the Adhinam. I have a scan. Maybe it's at the Madurai Kamarajar University. I don't know. Who has the original? I don't know. But I have the scan. Madurai Kamarajar University also has published the book called Madurai Temple Complex History. I was really surprised, but it's a wonderful news to share with you all. After thorough study, after thoroughly analyzing, I am making this statement. Adi Shankaracharya, because I tried to cross verify whether the Shanmata Sthapana Kesigar and Adi Shankaracharya is the same person in multiple references. With all that references and studying, I am of the conclusion, opinion. Of course, with the Paramashiva's grace, I used my intuition also to see the Akashic records. Adi Shankaracharya ascended the throne of Shyamala Peetha Saranya Peetham in Madurai as 117th Guru Maha Sannidhanam with the Pattabhishega title, coronation title, Shanmatasthapana Kesigar. I am so happy that someway I am connected to Adi Shankaracharya. Adi Shankaracharya is my love, and what a personality, what a being. Just in 32 years, what he has done. Literally, coming down as Adi Shankaracharya and organizing the whole Hinduism. And today, whatever we know as Hinduism, it is the gift of Adi Shankaracharya. 117th Sannidhanam, Guru Maha Sannidhanam is Shanmata Thapana Kesigar. Because in the Rama, in the Madhuryadina Pravaram, the national anthem, introduction, Pravaram, the word Jagadguru and all that words, which no other Adhinam has, no other Adhinam in Tamil Nadu has a Sarvanya Pita title. Only Madhuryadinam as Sarvanya Pita title. So with all those references, only Shankara Parampara uses the word Sarvanya Pita for their mutts and adhinams. Only Shankara Parampara uses the title Jagadguru. Other than Shankara Parampara, Shankaracharya mutts, only Madhuryadinam as the title Jagadguru traditionally. So with all the cross references, the historical points, dots put together, and the book published by my own Sannidhanam, 292nd Guru Maha Sannidhanam, Srila Sri Arunagirinatha Jnana Sammandha Desika Paramacharya Swamigal. Swamiji has published a beautiful book called Madurai Adhina Varalaru. From that book also, I analyzed all the references and that pravara published by my Sannidhanam, my Guru Maha Sannidhanam, Srila Sri Arunagirinatha Jnana Sammandha Desika Paramacharya Swamigal. I have analyzed thoroughly. Only after that I am making this statement. I know many people will attack me for making this statement. One side, the attack may come even from modern day Shankara followers. Attack may come even from the modern day Shaiva followers. I don't know. But I am not going to lie to the world. I have done enough research and all the documents. I have done research. Whatever evidences I have, I will be happy to publish it to the world. The Sthana Varalaru, Sthanigar Varalaru, the book by my own Guru Maha Sannidhanam, Srila Sri Arunagiri Jnana Sammandha Desika Paramacharya Swamigal, the pravaras, recorded pravara means introduction. It's like a national anthem. When a Sannidhanam comes, the chant, Brudavali, chanted, that is the national anthem for that samsthana. And each kingdom, each samsthana has their own Brudavali and national anthem. So all that, after studying all of it, and the functional structure, the titles of various mutts, adhinams, monasteries, and many books published by Shankara Sampradaya, Sringeri Mutt and Kanchi Mutt, and the time, historical references. I have done lots of study. Still, I am not able to match the year. Which year? I am not able to pin which year Adi Shankara has ascended the throne. Because he sings about Jnana Sammandhar in Saundarya Lahari, Dravida Sisu. And Madhuryadina Pravaram also calls Jnana Sammandhar as Dravidaveta Pravartaka. So the Dravida Sisu word is directly associated to Jnana Sammandhar. So with all these, I am able to come to a conclusion. Adi Shankaracharya ascended the throne of Shyamala Pita Sarvanya Pitam in Madurai as 117th Guru Maha Sannidhanam. That much I am able to come to the conclusion. The year I am not able to pinpoint. That still I am working, trying to find the references. I am also of the opinion that Jnana Sammandhar's commonly accepted age, the year, number of, the era. From my experience, from my analysis, I feel it's little early. Commonly it is accepted maybe 7th century or something like that. And I feel it's little earlier because Adi Shankaracharya is the successor, means after Jnana Sambandhar. That is why he sang about Jnana Sambandhar in Saundarya Lahari. So the exact year I am not able to pinpoint, but I am able to come to this much of conclusion that Adi Shankaracharya ascended the throne of Shyamalapita Sarvanyapitam in Madurai. He was coronated with the title Shanmada Thabana Thesigar as 117th Guru Mahasannidhanam. That much I am able to come to conclusion. Because too many things Shankaracharya has picked up from Shyamalapita Sarvanyapitam tradition and replicated when he established 6 mutts. From my analysis, I personally believe Shankaracharya established 6 mutts. Sringeri, Dwaraka, Puri, Badrikashram, Kanchi, Kashi. Kanchi as Mulamnayapitam, Kashi as the Urdhvamnayapitam. So 6 mutts Shankaracharya himself has established, and from many existing Sarvanyapita he ascended and had formal Pattabhishekam and guided them for certain period. Like Kashmir Sarvanyapitam he ascended, the Kashmir Sharada Sarvanyapitam he ascended, on that peetam had Pattabhishekam, and from that Sarvanyapitam he guided people for some time. And same way Kashi Darvasa Sarvanyapitam, before Shankara he ascended that Sarvanyapitam also, and then he himself established one more mutt. And Madurai Sarvanyapitam, Shyamalapita Sarvanyapitam he ascended and he guided that mutt as Guru Mahasannidhanam maybe for some time. Revived, organized, structured, inspired, then he might have continued his Parivarajaka Yatra, his journey further. So in Kanchi also, when he came to Kanchi, there was a Sarvanyapitam. He ascended that Sarvanyapitam at coronation. Then he also established another new mutt, which is the present Kanchi Kamakoti Peetam. From Adi Shankaracharya, the Guru Parampara comes. So understand, after doing thorough study, I am making this statement. And I have enough of historical evidences, references collected for the statement I am making. I have done a lot of study and then only I am making this statement. And I know the repercussions, and people, the historians or some people may try to attack me for this statement I am making. But I will tell whatever is historically true, I will share it with the whole world. Because both sides may not want Adi Shankaracharya being associated with Madurai Shyamalapita Sarvanyapita. And but I'll reveal the truth as it is. I have a deep devotion for Adi Shankaracharya and deep devotion for Jnana Sambandhar both, and absolute integrity to my Guru Parampara. The whole Guru Parampara, 292 Guru Mahasannidhanams. I have absolute integrity to the whole Guru Parampara. So naturally, whatever scientific, historical records, documents I am collecting, I am studying, research I am doing, I will reveal all the results of those researches to all of you. Let me come back to the subject, Tyaga. Tyaga will make you have a stomach like Adi Shankaracharya, which can grind and digest anything. Madurai Kamarajar University has published a lot of relevant historical records about the Madurai Adinam and Madurai whole temple history, the whole Shyamalapita Sarvanyapita history, and also the Leelarnavam, Shiva Leelarnavam, the official documentation of Meenakshi's life story. All of that also gives lot of insights and understandings about the Guru Parampara and the functionality of Shyamalapita Sarvanyapitam.